you know, others being healed becomes very, very important for her. So I'll move into a story about Ashwini Kumars. Okay. The story about Ashwini Kumars is of Ashwini Kumar and Sukanya. Sukanya was the wife of Chhayavan Rishi, but before becoming the wife of Chhayavan Rishi, Sukanya was a princess. Chhayavan Rishi was doing his meditation in the forest, okay, to the extent that his body grew old, and on his body was became a huge mound of anthill. Okay, and all that could be seen from that was the two eyes. So, and what happened was Sukanya was in an entourage with her father. She had come to the forest for a picnic or for a stay, for a shikar, that is for hunting and things like that. And she sees a mound of ants there, and she's very curious. So she goes and she peeps, and she sees that there are two twinkling objects within the mound. And then what she does is she pricks that with a stick. Blood starts pouring out from that mound. She gets very frightened and she moves out from there. Now the king, after he comes back, he starts getting bad omens about his kingdom. And consequently, a few things happen such that which are not conducive for his kingdom. At this time, the few rishis who come to the help of Chhayavan, and they also by their divine powers realize that it is Sukanya who has done some mistake. So they go to the king and they say that, see, it's your daughter who's done this mistake. So she will have to repay that. And he's old, because with his tapas so long that he's done the tap, he's become old. So the king is a little afraid about it, but Sukanya says, no, I'll marry him. And because of me, he has lost his eyes, and I want to marry him, and I will take care, good care of him. So everything is agreed. He's an old person, but he's very much in love with his wife, because she's very, being a princess, getting married to a rishi, living in very austere conditions. He agrees to, he sees the dedication that she has for him. So he has a lot of love and affection over a period of time developed for her. Now, she's taking care of her husband through and through. And these Ashwini Kumars, they're very naughty, very prankster kind of people. And they're traveling the earth. They're traveling the skies, not just the earth, they're traveling the skies. So what happens is they come to the earth once, and what they see here is that this lady is assisting a very old man. She is a princess. She looks like a princess because she's unadorned. She doesn't wear jewelry anymore and things like that. But the aura around her is that of a very beautiful lady, very princess-like. And so they approach her and say, why are you tending to this old man? So she goes and says that, look, this old man happens to be my husband. So they say, your husband? She says, yes, he's my husband. And she tells them the story. So they say, it's okay, you can always leave. You've done enough for him. Now you can leave and you can get married to any one of us. And she gets really irritated with them. And she says that by the tapa I have now gained as his wife, I can actually curse you. So they realize their mistake. So they say, okay, fine, we'll help. We are the Ashwini Kumars, and we are the celestial doctors. We're supposed to help everybody. Why not your husband? So we will help your husband also. So she says, okay, fine, thank you. Nothing like it. So they say, but she understands that there is a disclaimer attached. So she says, okay, so what is the disclaimer to this? So they say that after we have healed him, we all will take a dip, and then amongst the three of us, you have to choose your husband. Whoever you choose as your husband, because they are twins, okay, so they look alike.
Oh, okay.
And they will give him their form.
Oh, okay.
So you have to choose amongst the three of them.
Okay.
And whoever you choose becomes your husband.
Okay.
So she, at the cost of her satitva, okay, at the cost of her love, affection, devotion, dedication to her husband, she says, okay, not to worry. We'll see when the time comes. At least first and foremost, get him cured, because it's very important that he gets back his vision. So they all go and take a bath in the river. The Ashwini Kumars get the healing powers and they give him his eyesight back. They take a dip in the river. The dip, they transform him into a like of themselves. Once they transform him into a like of themselves, what happens? They all come out and they all say that it is me who is your husband. Okay. Now this lady is very smart. This lady is very smart. She realizes that there's only one who can help her. So she prays to the Ashwini Kumars that please help me find my husband. Are you getting the point here? So she, the tricksters are now getting them back. So the Ashwini Kumars are very happy with her. And they say, okay, they transfer his, so she can then see who her husband is in her image, in her mind, okay? And she pinpoints her husband and she, in his, restored his, not just his vision, even his youth. So they bless her, they tell her that may you have a very beautiful life together, and they move ahead. So they're supposed to be these people, you know, these people who have a planet in Ashwini Nakshatra, they're supposed to be very jovial. You know, they will have a sense of naughtiness about them and they will have a sense of sarcasm, pranksters, you know. And they help women. They help unaided women. So anywhere when you're traveling, girls, ladies in special who are listening to this, if you're traveling and you feel unsafe, please call upon the Ashwini Kumars to help you for a safe travel.
Yes.
So they're also healers. As you've just seen, the healers, and they have a dual personality, split personality. You can see that they are more than one. Okay, and they get very easily appeased by penance. So anybody who is calling upon them with a lot of love, affection, lot of penance, and lot of in truth, you know, you can just say, okay, please come, you please come, and in your mind you're talking about something else, thinking about something else, thinking wrong deeds. Trust me, they're not going to come. They are children. And children invariably have the ability to read your aura. So they will come to only those people who call them with a very strong reverence. They come. And they help in reconciliation. So here they got the husband and wife reconciled. So if Ashwini Kumars are called upon for reconciliation, they do come.
Okay.
Okay, so if you're having a problem in your married life, or if you're having a problem with a friend of yours on a Ashwini Nakshatra day, when moon is transversing through Ashwini Nakshatra, if you call upon the Ashwini Kumars, they come upon to you to help you. But let me here give you a disclaimer. If it is not fated for you, if it's a minor change that can help, they'll come. If it's not fated for you, they may show certain, restraint into coming in to help for you. They will come if you call them repeatedly, but they may show certain restraint. Okay, so let's take up a case of laughter and sense of humor. This laughter and sense of humor is that we see in Swami Deonanand. And he is Steve Berryman, and he is very serious about laughter. If you read about his about him on Wikipedia, you will know that he has helped many a people come out of depression very different manner, and he's gone about creating workshops about laughter, about humor, and he's given humor a very different perspective, and he's helped people to live a fulfilling life with humor. He has his ascendant in this nakshatra. So that's what he was born to do. Okay. And we will see that Ketu is in the eighth house, which is the nakshatra lord. Ketu here means what? It means transformation in the eighth house. So transforming people's life with laughter is what Swami Bhavananda is very famous for. And that's his life calling.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
And if you see, Ketu is with Venus, the seventh lord of secondary profession. So that's what his profession is all about. So, okay, they're also very good crisis managers. You know, they make very good crisis management and investors. Why investors? Because a lot of story attached to it, because we do not have that much of time to cover each and every story that I cover in my courses. This entire thing takes up around 5 hours to just me doing the lecture bit. And after that, when we have a session, it continues to around 6-7 hours, but that's in the class. So we have crisis management here, and crisis management is associated with their ability to move in fast wherever they are called, wherever they find a need, wherever it is important for them. So we have this Scottish investor Robert Watson Watt was a Scottish inventor and electronic engineer who developed the radio locator. It is the British equivalent of American radar, considered to be one of the most effective defense mechanisms against German air strength during 1940 and World War II battle of Britain. For his achievement, he received many honors, including knighthood in 1942. You will see that he has his ascendant, Sun, and Mercury. Sun is the fifth lord of power, intellect, proper use of the knowledge, okay, and research. And Mercury is the third lord of courage. Mercury is the third lord of communication. Mercury is also the sixth lord of service. Here you see this Mercury is retrograde again. So what does this retrograde Mercury signify? Instead of too much of talking or too much of telling or communicating, he also has invented a communication device.
Oh.
Okay, and it's more in a physical form rather than communication as Mercury is all about. Service here is also in physical form rather than not going and helping others, but inventing something that would help everybody.